class. I am Pooja Verma, going to take my lecture on subject concept of programming language in C. Okay, as in previous lecture of module 2, we can go through the arithmetic operator. As I am starting the lecture on operators, there are several operators like arithmetic, logical, bitwise, relational, comma, conditionals, and so on. So now in this lecture I am going through the bitwise operator and logical operators. So first of all, we need to learn about each and every operator's meanings, then syntax of that operators, and then calling of that operators in the programming, and the use of operators as per questions. Okay, so start with the bitwise operators. By its name, we can say that the operators basically apply on bit only. Bit means what? A single bit, like 0 or 1. Actually, the computer can understand the binary format, and there are only two bits, either 0 or 1 bit. Okay, and then when we read only single bit, then this is known as the bitwise operator. That means the operators that perform their actions over a single bit, not a whole bit. Like if I say that number 2, so the bit representation of number 2 is 10, but the operators will perform the operations on only 0, either on 1, not on both at the same time. Okay, so bit operators are basically used to operate on the integers and character. This is the most important part to be learned about, that which operator is basically used for which type of data types. Like in the previous, arithmetic basically used for the integer, float, double, long only. Okay, similarly here the bitwise operator is basically used for the operations on the integers and characters. Do not take place directly. That means what? We can't perform any actions on direct basis. We just go through only bitwise. Actual operation is performed by binary number 0 and 1s only. Okay, I already told you when I am going through the introduction of bits, either 0 and 1. So the action basically performed on the 0 and 1s formally. Okay, so now there are 7 in this table. Basically I mentioned the all the bitwise operator like comments, which is known as the 1s complement, then right shifting, then double diagonal to the double less than equal, less than symbol is basically known as the left shifting, then and ampersand 10, which is known as here bitwise, and then hyphen, basically here known as the bitwise OR, and then power, which is here known as the bitwise exclusive OR. That means what? The symbol, which meaning, general meaning is different, but when this symbol is basically used in the programming language, the meaning of that symbols will be changed. The meaning of that symbol will be do the work accordingly the definitions like 1s complement, right shifting, left shifting, bitwise AND, bitwise OR, and bitwise exclusive OR. So go through one by one operators. What is the 1s complement? What is the AND, OR, right shifting, left shifting, and so on. So while doing the bitwise operator in the program, the number that provided will be decimal format only. The first convert takes place from decimal to binary, and the operation from binary to decimal. That means what? First we need to convert the given data into the binary format, then we perform the operation over this binary data, and after that, when our operation is completed, then we need to convert that binary into the decimal. Because of what? Because data is given by the user in decimal format, so user also want the output in only decimal format. To conversion from decimal to binary, and it is basically used to for the computer system, because computer can understand the binary number system, and as it operator works on the only bitwise, so must be we can need to convert any data which is provided by the user into the binary format. Okay, so go through the 1s complement. What is a 1s complement? In the case of binary operations, when we go through the 1s complement, then we don't have much efforts to perform to convert any number, given number, into the ones complement. This is a very simple method. Just change the all the ones comes into the series of bit, like 0 and 1 bit, sequence of any 0 and 1. Just convert the all ones by 0 and all 0 will be changed to by 1. For example, if the given data is that 011001, and then question is that find the ones complement that number. So what we do, at the place of 0 we just write 1, and at the place of 1 we go through the 0. Again 0 is 1, 0 is 1, and 1 is 0. So this is our final answer. This is our final answer after converting the after converting the all ones into the 0 and 0 into the 1s. So go through the next operator, which is what? Which is the right shifting. So like take also one example in the programming concept, like when we write the this code int b, like int b comma a equal to 5, then b is equal to 1's complement of a. That means in the parameter b we need to save the data of a, 1's complement of a. Okay, now go through the complement of a. So first the given question is what? A is equal to 5. So what action will be performed by the compiler? First it need to change this decimal value into the binary value. The value of binary is 101. Then what? The complement f is equal to what? All the ones change by 0 and 0 change by 1s. So final output on the screen will be stored 010. Okay, and but what will be the value of b? The equivalent of 010 in the decimal format. In the decimal format, the value of complement of 5 is equal to 2. So you just check this question by typing this question on the turbo c, and then check your output. What is the output of this? Is equal to 2 or not? Okay, because of the equivalence of this binary code is equal to 2. So just check it by using your programming language. Okay, so now go through the second operator, which is known as the right shift operator. In the case of the right shift operator, we shift the bit to the right, but not all bits. Shift at a time only one bit, like if there are 001, then we change only, then we shift our rightmost bit into the rightmost bit. Okay, like how we can perform the action in this, we can see with the help of example. So the number of place or bit that to be shifted are given as a right hand operand. Like bit pattern is 10101, then must be shifted by 2 place. This will be given in your question. That means how much place you want to shift in right at a time, 1 or 2 or 3 and 4. This is basically given after the 4 shifting of right shift operator, give me the answer. Either one shift of operator, give me the answer, and so on. So how we can provide the number, like 2 times of right shift, 1 times of right shift, 3 times of right shift. The syntax of writing this is basically given like this. That means a right shift 4. That means what? The value of a will shift right shift operator by shifting 4 times by help of right operators, right shifting operators. Okay, so in this question the number of right shift is given by limit 2 only. So in the case of first shift, we just place at the first bit 0, and then first bit of given question will be become second bit, then second bit of question will be become the answer of third bit, then second bit, third bit of question is known as fourth bit of question, then answer, and then fourth bit of question is known as the last bit of your answer, and the last rightmost bit will be go as a discard. Okay, now again second shift, then second shift not perform on the given question. Now the second shift is performed on the over the first shift operation. Okay, so first shift is what? 0 1 0 1 0. Again we just discard the last bit, right, again from second rightmost to the leftmost, then right way 1 0 1 0. But there are total how much number of bits? 5. Here we get only 5, 4. So at the leftmost we just add the 0 only. Okay, so this is known as the right shift operator. If this is given as the cyclic right shift operators, then what will be happen? The discard bit not be discarded, like that means the last bit is not discarded, it just go to the, it will be become the first bit of the next shift. Okay, like 01010, then this 0 will become the first bit of second shift and our other bit will be placed at one position ahead. Okay, so here the question is given as int a is equal to 50, then print the value of a shifted 4 times. So what we do here, we need to convert a equal to 50 into the binary number. So we get the binary number 110010. Then we change right shift for the 4 times. So this is the step by how we can shift. First we shift the 0, then we get the result in this, then we shift the 1, then we get the result of second shift, then we shift the shift 3, then we get the result of third shift, and sorry 0, then we get the result of second shift, third shift, and then we get the this of fourth shift, and when we shift this only, then we get the final shift operation. Okay, so this is the basically our answer. So not this only, I as already told you that first we need to change the decimal into the binary, and then after the shifting operator we need to calculate the into the binary number into the decimal number. So the our output of this program code is equal to 3. So now go through the left shift operator. There are no change in the left shift and right shift, only one point is changed, that in the case of right shift operator we need to discard at the right most bit. In the case of left shift operator, we need to discard the leftmost bit position. Okay, and at the end of rightmost, we just add the number of 0. Like in this question, the question is given 10101. So what is happening here? This 1 is discarded, this 1 is discarded, this 0 will become 0, then 1, then 0, then sorry, this is also 1 10, and then 1 here. Then at last what will be happened here? At last we just add the 0. So this is the final answer, 10101, and at last what is added? 2 times 0. Okay. So in the case of 50, we just perform this 11th at, we got this, but output of this program is just equivalent of this decimal, this binary number. Bitwise AND operator. The syntax of bitwise AND operator is single ampersand. I already told you what is meaning of ampersand in the syntax of scanf and printf. In that position, it is basically used to provide the location of that variable, but here it perform as a bitwise operators. Okay. What is the meaning of AND? Logically, the meaning of AND is equal to true when the both value of given operand is true, but in the case of AND it is totally different. How it is different? In this case basically it is used to perform the ANDing the between two binary number. So how it is possible? It is perform the ANDs between the two numbers, and when both bit is equal to 1, then final output of AND bitwise AND is 1. So just look at the table 00, there are no one at both positions, so output is 0. 0 and 1, not both are 1, so value is 0. 1 and 0, not both are 1, so value is 0. So when the AND value is 1, the AND value is become 1 when the both operand, that means both bit will be 1. So output of this two binary number, the output of these two binary number and bitwise AND operation on these two binary numbers, so check one by one only, one bit at a time. So bitwise operator, the last bit of first value and last bit of second value is both are 0. So according to the truth table, value is 0. 1 and 0, output is 0. So 0. 0 and 1, so 0 and 1, output is 0. 0. 1 and 1, 1 and 1 gives the 1. Then again 1 and 1, the output is 1. 0 and 0, value is 0. 0 and 1, value is 0. 1 and 0, value is 0. So this is our bitwise and result over these two binary numbers. So again, I just repeat you that the bitwise operation basically perform on the binary number. So we must convert the data into the binary, and then over the binary number we need to perform our operations, and after that we need to convert that binary number into the decimal for the user friendly output. Basically not we, just compiler work, it is just compiler work in the background. So now go through the bitwise OR. Similarly like our logical operators, the OR will be perform the value 1 when any one value is 1. That means when we go through the 2 bit operation, when we go through the bitwise OR on the 2 bits, given bits, and if any one bit are 1, that means there are only 2 possibility of bit, either 0, either 1, and if any one is 1, then whole bit OR operation gives the result as a 1. So just look at the table and look at the difference here. Bitwise OR is used to perform OR operations between the two binary numbers with using this table. So 00 gives the result 0, 0 and 1. So if any ones 1 occur, then what is output is 1. Then 1 and 0 value is 1. 1 and 1 then also 1. So just let's take an example over this method. 100 11010. The next binary number is 010 111101. So just do your work accordingly to bitwise. Okay, so check 0 and 1. 1 is occurred, so output is 1. 1 and 0, 1. 0 and 1, 1. 1 and 1, 1. 1 and 1, 1. Both numbers are 0, so output is 0. 0 and 1, 1. 1 and 0, 1. So this is your bitwise OR. Now go through the bitwise exclusive OR. What is the bitwise exclusive OR operators? Basically, the exclusive OR operators can be called as XOR in the case of logically. And it is represented as a power symbol in the C operations. The truth table is different as compared to the AND and OR, bitwise AND and bitwise OR operators. The main difference is between if and only one bit out of two returns one. Okay, that means what? If there are only one bit is 1, that means odd number of 1 occurred, then value is 1. If even number of 1 occurred, then value is 0. This is the simplest method. The answer will be the 1 when the in question your odd number of 1 occur. If in your question even number of 1 occurred, then value is 0. So how it is performed? Basically again we go through the bitwise, that means bit by bit of two numbers, given numbers, we can check. Okay, so let's take the examples here. What is exactly happened here? 0 and 0. So number of ones is even, value is 0. 1 and 0. How many number of ones? Only 1. So value is 1. 0 and 1, 1. 1 and 1. How many number of ones occur here? 2. That means even number of ones occur. So value is 0. Even number of 1 occurred, 0. Even number of 1 occurred, 0. Odd number of 1, 1. Odd number of 1, 1. Okay, so this is the result value of AND over these two binary numbers. Okay, so at the end of this slide, we can easily learn the bitwise operator. Now go through the logical operators. How the logical operator is different, little bit difference compared to the bitwise operator, we can see and we can learn easily with the help of several examples. Logical operators. There are mainly three operators being used in case of logical. Okay, so how it is possible? In the case of the logical operations, there are three operators: AND operator, OR and NOT. So go through the one by one truth table of these operators. Here the column name is A and B, that is two operand on which we need to perform these operators. So how we can perform these operators, go through one by one. This is the AND, logical AND operators. Okay, so just clear out, if just writing that AND, so we think about logical AND. Whenever the question is asked about bitwise AND always mention that bitwise and. Okay, for the logically, never mention about the logical and, only writing that and operator. So you always think that by default, if it's asking about and, then we go through the logically and. If it want to bitwise, then it mention bitwise and. Okay, so what is the and according to the logically? Here also, if the both operand value is true, then whole result is true, otherwise zero. Okay, in the case of R, if the both value are zero, then value is zero. If any one value is one, then whole value is one. Not one, you can say only one is for true and zero is for false. That means if any value is false, then whole value is false. If both value are true, then true for the AND. In the case of OR, if any one value is true, then whole value is true. When the both value are false, then value is false. What is the NOT of A? NOT of A means what? Just complement of A. If 0, then 1, 0, then 1, 1, then 0, 1, then 0 here. So what is the exactly? Just component of, complement A. 0 by 1, 1 by 0. So this is true, false, then value is true. This is false, then NOT of A is true. If A is, then if simple A is true, well, have true value, then NOT of A has false value. Similarly, again, true, then value is false. Similar for the NOT of A, here the performance will be occurred over the B truth value also. Okay, when the B value is 0, that means false, then the NOT B value is 1. And if it's 1, then value is 0, and so on. So here the definition about the AND operators, we can see according to the truth table that the truth table show that if AND is used, then both the condition must be written as truth factors. Where it is mentioned here, when the both value are true, then truth factor of this operator is true. Okay, this is because true and true is true. Then this condition, it is satisfied, then the statement inside if statement is executed. Actually, the logical operator is used in the decision making statements. Okay, if and else, sometimes used also in the case of for and so on. But 90% logical operators being used in the case of if and else statements. Okay, suppose when the AND is used and any one of the condition returns false, then whole value is what? Whole value is false. According to the if statement, then it go through the else part. Now go through the OR operators. Already I defined in the case of truth table that when any one value is true, then whole value is true. So what is written here? Just say the case of handling OR operator is different as compared to the AND. And when the OR is used, then any one of the condition must be written a true value. That means if any one of the condition is true, then whole value is true. Any one value is true, then resultant value is true. When the both value are false, then resultant value is false. Not is basically used to result the expression in result like, reverse like. If the result is true, then after being using not, the result will be false. Okay, so go through the programming parts. So we can go through the easy understanding about writing the program using these operators. How we can apply the logical AND in the given questions. How we can understand which operator being used, AND or NOT. This is the most important part to create the logic before writing any program sections. Okay. So here the two variables value A and B is given, where A is 5, B is 3. So question is that when A is greater than B and A minus B is less than A, then we go through the this, else we go through the out of this loop. So what is happening here? According to the question, we just perform relational operator and AND operator. So go through this, checking this according to the question. A greater than B, so value is what? 5 greater than 3. So what is the value at the place of A greater than B? 2. And A minus B is less than equal to A. So what is the value of A minus B? Is 2. 2 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, 2 is less than 5. So true and true. So according to the AND operator, what is the value of true and true? when the both value are true and true, then whole result will be true. That means we go through the this whole value of is true, so we go through the this sections. Not explaining much here because you don't know any idea about the if and else statements. So just think that when this situation is correct, then we go through the if statements, like print this part and print this part. Okay, so here I also mentioning that when the condition is true and true, then whole value is true, and then we go through the if scope area, means inside the curly braces will be printed on script. So now go through the program. Basically this program is written of above program, where we go through the true part and else part. That means when the this condition is satisfied, that means whole value is of if is true, then what action will be performed, and when the value of a greater than b and a minus b greater than 0 is false, then what we perform. Okay, so what is here actually the value is given. That means predefined value, like initialize value into the variables. We can also take the value from the user also. Then what we did? We did a comma b and printf, scanf for a, printf integers number b, then scanf for the b. And then we write this code from here to the end. So perform a greater than b. When this value is true, we need to print on the output a is equal to value, then b is equal to value, a minus is value from getting here. Okay, similarly this and this, and else what? The truth value of AND operator is false. That means according to the truth table of AND operator, the above questions, above condition is not true, so value is false. And here the condition, there are two condition is given and check. Either this condition is true, either this condition is true. If any one condition is true, then whole value is true. And if the both value are true, then also the whole value is true. Okay. So according to question, this is also performed here. So this is a basic use of the logical AND. This is an important question by which we can learn how to apply, how to decide which operator must be taken here. Okay. So here the question is, write a program in C language to accept the age from the user and print whether the minor or major age, and also print an appropriate message for the age below the 1 or the age above the 100. So just be concentrate on the point or the age. That means either the age is below than 1 or the age is above than 100, the resultant will be what? Just show an appropriate message like invalid age. Okay, please add enter the age into the cycle, that means into the range and so on, because this is invalid age. Okay, in general. Okay, so and then another part is what? Accept the age from the user. That means user can insert the age either 2, either 3, 4, 5, 50, 60, 99, till 99, from 2 to till from 1 to 100 also, because there are question is less than 100. So less than 100 means 99, from the range 2 to 99. Okay, so go through the 2 to 99, divide this age group 2 to 99 into the two parts, minor age and major age, and so a message for the 1 or 100 that this is invalid age. So just take an parameter age, sorry, a variable declared in type age, and print, take the number from age from the user and print that, take the input for the help of a scanner, and then again apply your conditions, like if the age is less than 1 or greater than 100, then what? The age must be between 1 and 100. Your age which is you insert here is invalid. Okay, so your age, I want the display that entered age, so that why I need here format specifier, and also so that you will enter here. Okay, now I divide that if the age is between 18, 1 to 8, less than 18, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 till 17. When the range from 1 to 17, then person will becomes under the age minor. When the range from 18 to 59, okay, either you can write less than equal to 59, either you can write less than 60. Okay, because here it means what? Till 59. And if I apply just less than 60, then till 59 also. Okay, because less than 60, not less than equal to 60. Okay. So now our range is 18 to 59. I just divide that the person will be age of this is known as major age. Now above than 60 until the age equal to 100 is known as the age incomes under the senior citizens. Okay. And the output of this program is what? The age is, if the age is 5, then person will be the 5 minor. If the second output is enter the age, like someone enter the input as 0, then this age will be the must be invalid. And so on. These are three types of resultant value I show here. So this is basically the lectures on the two operators. The one operator is bitwise and or not. And the next operator is logical and or not. Okay. Hope you can understand this language, this C program better with the help of these notes and so on. And if you have any query, then you can ask me, you can comment me, you can comment your question, you can drop your question in the comment box and so on. So thank you class. Have a good day.